What's going on, guys? Beastly Gamer here. Welcome to the channel. Today, I'm here to announce that PlayStation 4 was once again the top-selling console for the month of March 2016. Now, I don't know how much of a surprise this is for you guys. For me, it really isn't one. I'm more anxious to see what happens in the future once the PS4.5 is released and what that's going to do as far as moving units. And if in fact, it will affect the Xbox One at all. I'll drop a link in the description. PS4, the top-selling console in the U.S. again during March 2016. More people played The Division on PS4 than Xbox One. Ahead of the release of today's NPD sales report for March 2016, Sony has released a statement proclaiming that PS4 is once again the best-selling console in the United States. Quote, "Thank you to our fans and partners for making PlayStation 4 the top-selling console and software sales leader for the month of March, as well as the number one console for fans of The Division. We are truly humbled by the success and look forward to delivering more amazing gaming experiences throughout 2016, including the launch of PlayStation VR this October," end quote. As is typically the case, we weren't offered any specific sales figures, given the PS4 sales have outpaced the Xbox One. It shouldn't come as a surprise that it is the top console for The Division. Still, it is noteworthy considering that the first two DLC packs will come to Xbox One before other platforms. Hardware sales across the industry were down 19%. To 253.2 million from 311.1 million during March 2015. Quote, "Video game hardware dollar sales declined by 19% in March 2016, with unit sales dropping 17%. The difference in trends was due to some softening of average retail prices of 2% versus last March," end quote. Portable hardware sales had the highest dollar sales volume decline versus last March, followed closely by 8th generation consoles. 7th generation consoles had a steep percentage decline of 78%, though those sales now represent only 2% of the month's sales. Accessory sales fared better, rising 9% to 285.1 million from 261.8 million last year. According to the NPD Group, this makes it the biggest March ever for accessory sales in the US. Quote, "Three types of accessories continue to propel overall accessory sales in 2016. Video game cards, game pads, and headsets. All experienced double-digit growth in March 2016 versus March 2015 and have sold $82 million more in Q1 2016 versus Q1 2015, end quote. Microsoft, which has made it clear it'll only be sharing non-sales related data going forward, highlighted the popularity of games with Xbox Live in its comment on today's report. Quote, "In March, global hours spent gaming on Xbox One increased 89% compared to last year. Xbox Live engagement was driven by the greatest games lineup, including new titles released in March like Killer Instinct Season 3 and Tom Clancy's The Division. Killer Instinct Season 3 has seen record engagement across Xbox One and Windows 10 since it launched on March 29th, making March the best month ever for the franchise with more than 6 million unique players. Last week on April 5th, we launched Quantum Break to critical acclaim and it became the best-selling Xbox game around the world and is now the best-selling new Microsoft Studios published IP this generation. Quote, "We can't thank our fans enough for their continued support. We're looking forward to bringing more unprecedented experiences on Xbox One, Windows 10, and Xbox Live later this year." Nintendo's statement centered around the performance of its software, making no mention of the Wii U or 3DS. So, they did that because the Wii U is dead. The Wii U is all but dead. I have a confession. I played my Wii U last night. Me and my son broke it out. We played some Smash Brothers. I put Bayonetta in, and I didn't play because my controller was actually dead. But yeah, the Wii U is dead. Quantum Break is selling really well. Xbox One, of course, their sales numbers are probably declined just like PlayStation's has. And PS4 won the month of March. Hope you guys enjoyed the video. And just a little bit of news. Sony PlayStation wins the month of March. What can happen to turn the tide from PlayStation to Xbox? Hope you guys enjoyed the video. If you did, give a thumbs up. Show support for my channel. If you're new to the channel, subscribe now. I'm the Beastly Gamer, and I'll see you guys next time.